everyone, and welcome to my new doll repaint video. A couple of weeks ago, in one of my doll transformations, I asked you for some fresh ideas of dolls that we could repaint. Because you know, I love working with Monster High dolls, with Barbie dolls, but I also love trying something new. I really adore experimenting with new kinds of dolls. And under that video, there were lots of comments about Winx Club dolls. Strangely enough, it wasn't that easy to find them here in Europe and Belgium. I don't know, maybe just something very specific for American market, or just, I don't know, something new, something old, something just not that popular. I don't know what was the problem, but I could find just probably 3 or 4 different kinds of dolls, different kinds of faces, I mean. So it was quite difficult to find, but I got one here, and this is such an adorable doll. She looks indeed very good. I see she has bendable knees, probably bendable elbows, but for this we'll have to open the box and to see how it looks in real. So let's start, because really it's the first time I see this kind of a doll, it's the first time I hold it in my hand, so I'm really curious to take a closer look. But what I can already say, that I really love her face mold. She's indeed very and very cute. So let's go. So here is our doll, and she is indeed very, very, very cute. I really love her face. I love the legs. They're bendable like the old Barbie legs, you see. And her arms, the elbows are also bendable, very similar. So there is no like a visible joint. I don't know, of course, maybe it's going to break very quickly. But for now it looks very good. What I don't like the outfit, but it doesn't really matter, we're going to make a new one anyway, because you see it doesn't really even fit properly, it's so kind, I don't know, messy and cheap. Oh, but I love her underwear. And I really love her long socks, yeah, and the shoes look also very cute, I think. So let's take it all off. I'm not really crazy about the quality of her hair. Is this cheaper hair? I normally see it on this cheaper styling Barbie doll heads. Oh yeah, we're going to solve it also very soon, because today we're going to cut off her hair completely. And I also don't really like here this neck joint, this peg in her head, because her head is turning just like this. She cannot really look up and down. But for the rest, I think it's a really cool doll. I really love her face. I really love the style, the proportions of this doll. Of course, all dolls are disproportional, but sometimes it looks cute and sometimes it looks not healthy. This time it looks cute, I think. So the next step is cutting her hair very short, and then I'm going to warm her head up with a hair dryer to make it soft, to be able to remove the head and to remove this hair that will still stay inside. So now we can see how this peg in her neck looks. And of course, with this kind of a construction, those head can rotate just right and left. It cannot go up and down, unfortunately. And this hole in her head is also very small, so it's quite difficult to go inside. But it's possible. When her hair is completely gone, I can take my pure acetone and remove her original face. After this, I'm going to spray this face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. The sealant will make this rubber surface matte and I will be able to draw on it with my pencils. But I have a little problem with her body. I don't really know what to do about it. I don't think I will be able to blush this doll's body like I regularly do it with my Mr. Super Clear sealant and soft pastels or with acrylic paint, and it's all because of this banding system. You know, I really like it, but you cannot repaint it like this. Because you see, if we bend her knees, here we see some sort of a line. You see this crack, like a wrinkle here. So, if I spray it with a couple of layers of the sealant, then I do again pastels, then again sealant, then again pastels, and then I bend the knees like this, all these layers of sealant and pastels, they're going to crack here, and from here it's all going to peel off, so it's going to become extremely messy, and it's not really a solution. And the same problem we have here with her arms, with the elbows. If I seal it with Mr. Super Clear and pastels or acrylics, here it's going to crack. So I think I will let this body just like it is for now. I'm going to repaint her face and then we will see. If the difference between the face and the body is really huge, then we will try to solve it in some way. Maybe blush just the body, like this part, the torso, or maybe I'm going to make some kind of an outfit with the long sleeves, maybe some socks, something like this. But for now, I will not start blushing this body with acrylics or with Mr. Super Clear sealant, because it's not gonna work, I promise you. And by the way, if we look at her face and her body right now, the color is not exactly the same. I don't know if you can see it on the camera very well, but this body is more brown-like and her face is a little bit more pinkish. But yeah, doesn't matter. I'm going to work just on her face right now and then later we will see what we're going to do with her body. And meanwhile, I have prepared pencils and pastels that I'm going to use today, and I think I want to give her green eyes, because lately I've made too many dolls with blue eyes already. And all the colors are very natural and gentle, and we're going for a sweet but very realistic look today. So first of all, I'm going to make all these pencils very, very sharp, and then I will sketch her eyes and eyebrows like always. Then I draw the nostrils and the line between the lips. And the next step is contouring her face with soft pastels. Eyelids I draw first with pencils and then I apply soft pastels on top of it to make the blending more perfect. add a touch of blush to her cheeks, and when I feel happy with the skin tone, I start to add more colors to her face. And I begin like always with white of her eyes, after this I draw the irises, and then I work on the waterline. And her eyebrows also deserve some more attention. Of course, I don't draw her face in one run. I use my Mr. Super Clear sealant all the time between the layers to protect the result of my work. And like this, I'm applying around 15-17 layers per doll. The next step is drawing the highlights, and here it's very important to blend the pencil really perfectly. Now I want to draw the bottom eyelashes, and then I'm going to add the brightest reflections to her eyes using white acrylics. Okay, her face is finished, I think, and now let's compare it to the body. And yeah, you see, even though I've really tried to not go too heavy with the contouring, anyway, you can see that the difference is huge, so I'm going to ask my mom to make an outfit with long sleeves and maybe some like long socks or something like this to cover the body, and like this you will not be able to see the difference. And you know what, of course, much better than me, than the Winx Club girls are basically some modern fairies. And I'm going to follow this legend because I really like it. And it means the next step of our transformation is creating a pair of wings for our doll. You can find, of course, probably 300,000 different methods explaining how to make wings for your Monster High and Barbie dolls. And here is another one to your collection. And today, to make these wings, I'm going to use my 3D pen. I'm going to use clear resin, and I'm going to use different kinds of glitter. So, let's start. You can see I've prepared here already a pattern of our future wings, and first of all I'm going to cover it up with a layer of tape, and then I'm going to build the wings using the 3D pen. Then I mix two components of resin together, and I'm going to split this mix in parts. I'm going to add different kinds of glitters to it, and then I will fill in the space inside of the wings with this resin. I have waited for about 18 hours and you see there is a lot of resin coming out of our 3D pattern. So I would like to get rid of it now when the resin is not completely hard yet, otherwise I might crack it and damage the resin. So now when it still feels kinda rubberish, I cut off all this mess from the sides of the wings and then I let the resin dry completely. Then I attach the wings to such a hair clipper and now I can wear them on any doll and with absolutely any type of an outfit. After this, I still want to customize these adorable sneakers, and first of all I cover them with silver acrylics, and after this I decorate them with glitter. And now let's take a look at my mom's outfit. I think it's ideal for modern fairy. The style is really quite similar to her original outfit, but it looks much more advanced, much more detailed. And I also love this pink color of the hoodie. It's not too aggressive, like a very soft and gentle pink color. So, and now I still need to make a wig for our doll, and honestly I just always forget about this step in the end. To me it feels already completely finished, but yet still quite a big part of work to do. And today I'm going to give my doll this beautiful, very light lavender color hair. I think it would fit absolutely amazing this style, this modern fairy style. It would also look beautiful with this dusty pink hoodie. So now I just need to turn this yarn, because of course it's not hair, it's just some regular 100% pure acrylic yarn coming from our local store. I bought it today for this doll especially. So now I need to turn this yarn into doll's hair, and if you watch my videos regularly, you know of course already all these steps. So first of all, I'm going to cut this yarn into shorter pieces. After this, I tie the pieces of yarn around barbecue sticks. Then I make the thread loose, and this yarn is very fine, so it takes a while, but I really love the color, so let's hope it's worth all this work. After this, I brush the yarn with this brush that I've bought for my cats already years ago, but I never got a chance to use it because they hate just an idea of this brush. And I remember you told me once the right name of it in the comments, but I've forgotten it, of course, again. And on this step, I got lots of this fluff, and we're going to use it later today to make something special. Then I make this fluffy yarn straight with a flat iron, and then I can cut it off the stick and apply tacky glue to this cut edge. And when the glue gets dry, I trim the glued edge and I make a wig for my doll using a glue gun. And I really love making yarn hair lately, guys, because these fibers, they look just perfect on doll scale. It gives an effect of real hair. And it's also much easier to style because something like two pigtails, two buns, I don't know, two braids, things like these, they always look too thick and too massive when you use regular doll hair. It's good for curls, for some locks, for making an effect of having a lot of gorgeous hair. And for the hairstyle I'm going to make today, this yarn hair will work better, I think. And when the wig is finished, I still want to attach the false lashes and to add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. And do you still remember this acrylic fluff we've got after brushing this doll's hair? Now I'm going to use a part of it to make a big and fluffy cotton candy for my doll. So I will need some of this yarn, these fibers. I will need a barbecue stick, white acrylics, yeah, and a drop of tacky glue. So, and now let's put it all together and then we'll take a look at the end result pictures. Here is my Winx Club girl. I think she looks amazing. I should definitely make more fairies because I'm simply in love with her wings. Why I almost never make wings here on my channel? I don't know, nobody knows probably. And I also love how her face looks because it's always so much fun working with completely new kinds of dolls with new face molds. And by the way, I've seen so many cool doll releases online. I would really love, for example, to get some of these Wild Hearts dolls. They're so-called new Monster High. And I really like their faces. They have normal human skin tones and they even have different body types, it seems. And there are also new LOL OMG dolls. They're very intriguing. It's like a Barbie-sized LOL doll. But all of them are in the USA, of course. And some are even exclusive to Walmart or to some other shops. So I'm thinking already about going doll shopping to the States, because even getting a Winx doll is a challenge here in Belgium. But I probably should find a better reason to come to the States than going doll shopping. So maybe we could organize something like, I don't know, workshops in some big cities. Then I could have a serious and a legit reason to cross the ocean, not just for buying some Wild Hearts dolls, because it's exaggerated, of course. But it's just an idea. Please tell me what you think here in the comment section down below. And this doll is now available for sale on eBay, and the link you can find like always in the description box. So, and that was my doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes, because it really helps me. It helps my channel, it helps my art. And like this, I can continue making dolls every week, Friday, again and again. Of course, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button. And I will see you already very soon, next week, Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.